Tomb in the altar. There's a big hole in the middle. You probably can't see from where you're sitting. We're going to put inside the altar relics of saints. Relics are little pieces of their bones, usually, or pieces of their body, like their hair, whatever, that was saved after they died. Three of the saints who pieces of their relics are going to be put in our altar tonight. One is Father Miguel Pro, who was shot to death in the 1920s in the Mexican Revolution. Father Miguel Pro did part of his seminary studies a few miles from here in Los Gatos at the Jesuit novitiate on the hill there, when the Jesuits and all religious were expelled from Mexico during the Mexican Revolution. He was shot to death for being a priest, for offering the sacrifice of the Mass, at a time in Mexico when it was forbidden. He became a sacrifice. We're also going to put in a relic of Mother Teresa of Calcutta, a person most of us, we've seen her on TV. We were alive when she was alive, most of us, if you think more than 10 years old. Mother Teresa, you know, she was probably one of the most famous women in the world. A man went to her and said, "Mother Teresa, you're doing such a good job. I'm going to raise money for you. I'm a professional fundraiser." And she said, "Excuse me, I don't want anybody raising money for me. If you like what we're doing, then you give. You donate." And then she said to the guy, "And you give until it hurts, until it becomes a sacrifice. And only then will you know the joy of giving?" Like the widow that Jesus talked about. And the other saint to be put in here is Pope Saint Pius X. Well, I don't know why this particular, I don't know how they were all chosen, Father, how you got your different saints, but Saint Pius X, I don't know if I should say this, but he's in my small list of saints who smoked, okay? Yeah, he smoked cigarettes and cigars and stuff, you know, not in public, you know, like, and all that, but he did. So it was kind of normal. So did Pope John the 23rd, but that's not why he became a saint, obviously. Saint Pius X was Pope around the time of World War I. Almost 100 years ago now. And if anyone here in this church, and I see there's a lot of you, are under the age of 16, if you're the age of 7 to 16, you should thank St. Pius X, because St. Pius X lowered the age at which children could go to Holy Communion. He was 16 and he lowered it down to 7, age 7. So otherwise you would have had to wait a lot longer. We would have had to go to communion. Pope Pius X, one of the patrons of the liturgy, one of the patrons of the Holy Eucharist, which we're about to receive in a few moments.